Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 21 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to solve problem in the isothermal flow. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the theory part of the isothermal flow. We defined the isothermal flow and we calculated the property variation in isothermal flow. And here we solve few problems from the in the isothermal flow using the gas tables. And at the end of the lecture, the learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, student will be able to solve problems in the isothermal flow. And this is the gas tables which we will be referring for solving the problem. There are three tables available for isothermal properties. Property change for the isothermal flow, 7.1 for gamma equal to 1.3, 7.2 for gamma equal to 1.4 and 7.3, table number 7.3 for gamma equal to 1.67. So, the property ratio, different property changes for isothermal flow, we can collect from table number 7.1, 7.2 and 7.3 respectively. And the example number 1, air enters a 15 centimeter diameter pipe at a pressure of 1.3 megapascal and a temperature of 20 degrees Celsius with a velocity of 60 meters per second. Assuming that the friction factor is 0.004 and that the flow is effectively isothermal, find the Mach number at a point in the pipe where the pressure is 300 kilopascal and length of the pipe at this point. So, we write down the given data. So, diameter of the pipe 0.15 meter, pressure P1 at the station section 1 is 1.3 megapascal, temperature T1 equal to T2 equal to T, which is 20 degrees Celsius, which is 293 Kelvin. Velocity C1 at the section 1 is 60 meters per second, friction factor F equal to 0.004. Pressure at section 2, P2 equal to 300 kilopascal. We take gamma equal to 1.4 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The Mach number at the entry, so from the data given, we calculate the Mach number at the entry, M1 equal to C1 divided by square root of gamma R T1, which is equal to T. So, this is 60 divided by square root of 1.4 into 287 into 293, which is 0.17. So, the Mach number at the pressure P2 equal to 300 kilopascal, we calculate M2 equal to M1 into P1 by P2. The relation between Mach number and the pressure, it is given by M2 equal to M1 into P1 by P2. So, substituting 0.17 into 1.3 into 10 power 6 divided by 300 into 10 power 3 equal to 0.74. And from isothermal table 7.2, page number 99 and 100, we refer two pages. For M1, it is on the page number 99 and M2 is 0.74, it is page number 100 and for gamma equal to 1.4. We take the ratio 4FL max divided by D. For M1 equal to 0.17, this is 20.7625 and M2 equal to 0.74, this is 0.0386. Now, the length of the pipe, we calculate the length of the pipe. So, we have this expression for isothermal flow 4FL divided by D equal to 4FL max by D at the Mach number M1 minus 4FL max by D at Mach number M2. So, substituting 4 into 0.004 into length is unknown divided by 0.15 equal to 20.7625 minus 0.0386 equal to 20.7239. So, L equal to 20.7239 into 0.15 divided by 4 into 0.004 equal to 194.3 meter. So, the answer to the problem, Mach number at the exit is 0.74 and length of the pipe equal to 194.3 meter. Example number 2, consider a subsonic airflow through a pipe with a diameter of 2.5 centimeter, which is Mach number, which is 3 meter long. At the inlet of the pipe, the pressure is 200 kilopascal, Mach number is 0.35. The mean value of friction factor may be assumed to be 0.006. Determine the exit Mach number assuming the flow is isothermal. So, we are given diameter equal to 2.5 centimeter, length equal to 3 meter, pressure P1 equal to 200 kilopascal, M1 equal to 0.35 and friction factor is 0.006. So, from isothermal table 7.2, page number 99, m1 equal to 0.35 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take 4 FL max by D at m1 equal to 0.03.0815. Now we have 4 FL by D is equal to 4 FL max by D m1 at m1 minus 4 FL max by D at m2. So 4 FL max by D at m2 equal to 3.0815, we have taken from the table minus 4 into 0.006 into 3 divided by 0.025 equal to 0.2015. Now refer to the gas table, isothermal table for this particular value, 4 FL max by D equal to 0.2015. So from isothermal table, page number 100, the Mach number corresponding to the value is M2 equal to 0.63. So the answer to the problem, Mach number at exit is 0.63. Example number 3, at a pressure of 550 kPa and temperature of 30 degrees Celsius, air at a pressure of 550 kPa and the temperature of 30 degrees Celsius flows through a pipe with a diameter of 0.3 meter and a maximum length of 140 meter. Assuming the flow is isothermal and average friction factor is 0.0025, find the Mach number at the inlet of the pipe and the mass flow rate. So we are given P1 equal to 550 kPa, T1 equal to 30 degrees Celsius, diameter equal to 0.3 meter, length equal to 140 meter, F equal to 0.005, maximum length, L max equal to 140 meter. We take gamma equal to 1.4 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. From the data given, for the given condition, 4 FL max by D equal to 4 into 0.0025 into 140 divided by 0.3 equal to 0.47. So from isothermal table 7.2, page number 99, Mach number corresponding to the above value is m1 equal to 0.555. Now air velocity at the inlet, c1 equal to m1 into square root of gamma rt1, which is 0.555 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 303 equal to 193.65 meters per second. Density of air at inlet condition, rho1 equal to p1 by r into t1, which is 550 into 10 power 3. Divided by 287 into 303 equal to 6.32 kilogram per meter cube. The mass flow rate through mass flow rate of air through the pipe, m equal to rho1 a1 c1, which is 6.32 into pi by 4 0.3 square into 193.65 equal to 86.5 kilograms per second. So the answer to the problem, Mach number at inlet of the pipe 0.555 and the mass flow rate is 86.5 kilograms per second. Example number 4, a 3 km long pipeline with a diameter of 0.1 meter is used to transport methane at a rate of 1 kg per second. The gas remains essentially at the constant temperature of 10 degrees Celsius and the pressure at the exit of the pipe is 150 kPa. Find the inlet velocity. Assume that the average friction factor is 0.004, methane has a molar mass of 16 and specific heat ratio of 1.3. So we are given the given data, length equal to 3 kilometer, which is 3000 meter, diameter equal to 0.1 meter, mass flow rate equal to 1 kilograms per second, T temperature equal to 10 degrees Celsius, which is 283 Kelvin, pressure P1 equal to 150 kPa, F equal to friction factor equal to 0.004, molecular weight of methane 16 and gamma equal to 1.3. For the given condition, we calculate 4 FL max by D. So 4 into 0.004 into 3000 divided by 0.1 equal to 480. From isothermal table, for gamma equal to 1.3, table number 7.1, page number 93, the Mach number corresponding to the above value is m1 equal to 0.04. The gas constant for methane, R equal to universal gas constant divided by the molecular weight, 8314.3 divided by 16 equal to 519.64 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the velocity of the air at inlet, C1 equal to M1 into square root of gamma RT, which is 0.04 into square root of 1.3 into 519.64 into 283 equal to 17.5 meters per second. The answer to the problem, velocity of gas at the inlet, it is 17.5 meters per second. Example number 5, in a refinery, a hydrocarbon gas at 25 degrees Celsius flows through a 150 meter long buried pipeline of 60 centimeter diameter. At the entrance, the average velocity is 150 meters per second and the static pressure is 2 bar. Assuming isothermal flow through the duct, calculate the static pressure, stagnation pressure, stagnation temperature the exit. Take the friction factor is 0.0034, molecular weight of gas is 16 and ratio of specific heat is 1.4. So we are given temperature equal to 25 degrees Celsius, which is 298 Kelvin, length equal to 150 meter, diameter equal to 0.6 meter, velocity C1 equal to 150 meters per second, pressure P1 equal to 2 bar, friction factor is 0.0034, molecular weight is 16 and the gamma equal to 1.4. The gas constant for the gas, R equal to universal gas constant divided by the molecular weight, 8314.3 divided by 16 equal to 519.64 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and the Mach number at the inlet for the given condition, M1 equal to C1 divided by square root of gamma RT1, which is 150 divided by square root of 1.4 into 519.64 into 298 equal to 0.32. Now, from the isentropic table 3.2, page number 29, at Mach number M1 equal to 0.32 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take P1 by P1 equal to 0.932, T1 by T1 equal to 0.979. We calculate the stagnation properties at the inlet, P1 equal to P1 divided by 0.932, which is 2 divided by 0.932 equal to 2.146 bar, T01 equal to T1 divided by 0.979, 298 divided by 0.979 equal to 304.4 Kelvin. Now, from the isothermal table 7.2, page number 99, at M1 equal to 0.32 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take all the properties, P1 by P star T equal to 2.641, PO1 by PO star T equal to 1.777, TO1 by TO star equal to 0.893 and 4 FL max by D equal to 4.033. Now, we have this expression 4 FL by D equal to 4 FL max by D for Mach number M1 minus 4 FL max FL max by D for the Mach number M2. Now we calculate 4 FL max by D for Mach number M2, which is 4.033 minus 4 into 0.0034 into 150 divided by 0.6, which is 0.633. Now for this value, 4 FL max by D equal to 0.633, we take refer to this isothermal table from page number 7.2, page number 9, table number 7.2, page number 99, corresponding to the above value, M2 equal to 0.53. M2 equal to 0.53 and we take other properties, P2 by P star T equal to 1.59 by 595, PO2 by PO star T equal to 1.21 and TO2 by TO star T equal to 0.924. Now, the properties of the gas at the exit, P2 equal to P1 into P2 by P1 star divided by P1 by P star T, which is 2 into 1.595 divided by 2.641 equal to 1.21 bar. PO2 equal to PO1 into PO2 by PO star T divided by PO1 by PO star T equal to 2.146 into 1.21 divided by 1.777 equal to 1.46 bar. TO2 equal to TO1 into TO2 by TO star T divided by TO1 divided by TO star T equal to 304.4 into 0.924 divided by 0.893 equal to 314.96 Kelvin. So, the answer to the problem, the properties at the exit, P2 equal to 1.21 bar, PO2 equal to 1.46 bar and TO2 equal to 314.96 Kelvin. Example number 6, air flows in a long pipe under isothermal conditions. At the inlet, the static temperature is 300 Kelvin, static pressure is 3 bar, Mach number is 5. The inner diameter of the pipe is 150 millimeter and average friction factor is 0.004. Calculate the length of the pipe required to change the Mach number to 0.6. Air conditions at the Mach number 0.6, length of the pipe at the choking condition, air properties at the choking condition. So, we write down the given data. At inlet, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, P1 equal to 3 bar, Mach number M1 equal to 5. At the outlet, M2 equal to 0.6, diameter equal to 0.15 meter and the friction factor is 0.004. From isothermal table 7.2, we take the properties. We take Mach number M1 equal to 5 and gamma equal to 1.4 and M2 equal to 0.6 and gamma equal to 1.4. So, we take the properties P by P star, PO by PO star and TO by TO star and 4 FL max by D. So, the values are taken. So, P by P star equal to 0.169 and 1.308. PO by PO star equal to 56.043 divided by 9.38, TO by TO star T equal to 5.25 divided by 1, and 1.126, 4 FL max by D equal to 2.584 and 0.299. Now, the length of the pipe, 4 FL by D equal to 4 FL max by D at Mach number M1 minus 4 FL max by D at Mach number M2. So, substituting 4 into 0.004 into L divided by 0.5 equal to 2.584 minus 0.299 equal to 2.285. So, length of the pipe L equal to 2.285 into 0.15 divided by 4 into 0.004 equal to 21.42 meter. From isentropic table 3.2 page number 38 at Mach number M1 equal to 5 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take P1 by PO1 equal to 1.89 10 power minus 3, T1 by TO1 equal to 0.167. So, the stagnation properties of the inlet, so PO1 equal to P1 divided by 1.89 10 power minus 3, which is 3 divided by 1.89 10 power minus 3 equal to 1587.3 bar, and the TO1 equal to T1 divided by 0.167, which is 300 divided by 0.167 equal to 1796.4 Kelvin. And at air conditions at exit for Mach number 0.6, we take P2 equal to P1 into P2 by P star divided by P1 by P star, which is 3 into 1.408 divided by 0.169 equal to 25 bar. PO2 equal to PO1 into PO2 by PO star divided by PO1 by PO star equal to 1587.3 into 0.938 divided by 56.043 equal to 26.6 bar. TO2 equal to TO1 into TO2 by TO star divided by TO1 by TO star equal to 1796.4 into 1.126 divided by 5.25 equal to 385.2 Kelvin. Length of the pipe at the choking condition. So, L max equal to 2.584 into 0.15 divided by 4 into 0.004 equal to 24.22 meter. The properties of the gas at the choking condition. So, P star T equal to P1 divided by 0.169, which is 3 divided by 0.169 equal to 17.75 bar. PO star T equal to PO1 by 56.043 equal to 1587.3 divided by 56.043 equal to 28.32 bar. TO star equal to TO1 divided by 5.25, which is 1796.4 divided by 5.25 equal to 342.2 Kelvin. And the answer to the problem. Length of the pipe required to change the Mach number to 0.6 is 21.42 meter. Air conditions at the Mach number 0.6 at the outlet, P2 equal to 25 bar, PO2 equal to 26.6 bar and TO2 equal to 385.2 Kelvin. Length of the pipe at the choking condition is 24.22 meter. Properties, air properties at the choking condition, P star T equal to 17.75 bar, PO star T equal to 28.32 bar and TO star T equal to 342.2 Kelvin. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in a mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. You can refer to the book for additional problem in the subject, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my WhatsApp number or mail ID for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again in another video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. Until then, bye-bye.